Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to Karim's Biology. You know, children, I have been taking a series of sessions on the lesson What is Science? And today's session will be session 7, in which we are going to discuss about reading to learn with reference to steps in reading. Okay, students, let us enter into the topic.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Reading to learn. Scientists use reading, writing, and numbers in their work. Dear students, when we were discussing about the scientific method, I told you that the first step in the scientific method is to observe the surroundings and asking the question. Okay, and when you ask a question or when you get a doubt in your mind, before you begin investigating about the question that you got, you should first of all gather the knowledge about the topic that you are going to do investigation about. And how can you do that? You can do that by referring to some books. Not only that, nowadays we can also refer internet. You can take the help of your mobile phone. You can ask your elders. So these are the various ways of getting information about the topic that you are going to investigate. And most important among all these things and most easiest one is to refer some books to know about the concept or about the topic that you want to investigate. And reading books is an important task for every student. Not only for student, especially for scientists, when they want to investigate, they have to gather knowledge which was already acquired by some other people. Because it is through acquiring the knowledge, they are able to further proceed with some different logics so that they can finally get a result, a desired result. And scientists read to find out everything about the topic they are investigating. So it is important that scientists, they know the meaning of science vocabulary and that they understand what they read. Not only scientists, my dear children, even yourself, when you want to solve some of the problems that you face in your day-to-day life, you sometimes also have to read books to acquire some knowledge about the topic of your investigation or to acquire some knowledge about the problem that you are facing. And how can you do that? The best method, as I told you, is reading some books related to the topic. So there is a procedure, there is a strategy that you have to follow while you read any book so that you can become a good science reader. And in this session, we are going to learn about what are different strategies that you have to follow when you want to learn about something from a book. So before you start reading a book, there are a few steps that you have to follow while doing that. And in this session, we are going to learn about that before starting reading the book, what you have to do. And while reading book, what you should do after completion of reading, what are your strategies. So these things we are going to learn now. So first of all, let us begin with before reading. That is, before you start reading the book, what you have to do. Read the find out statement to help you know what to look for. When you read any book, definitely you are trying to get knowledge about a particular concept. And when you try to read any book, the first and foremost thing that you have to do before you start reading the book is to find out the statement to help you know what to look for. In every book, in every page, there will be a statement that indicates what is given or what information is given in that particular page. So you have to read that find out statement first of all. For example, this lesson is about different ecosystems. And you can also see this find out, what is ecosystem. This is the heading, this is the subheading given. And below that a few paragraphs are given. So you need not read the entire paragraph to find out what is given in the paragraph. Even before you start reading this paragraph, you can come to know what is actually given in these paragraphs by looking at that find out statements. So what is given in this particular paragraphs? It is given about ecosystems. That's why it is most important for you to first of all see about the find out statements in any page before you start reading it. And you have to think, I need to find out what the parts of an ecosystem are and how they are organized. When you read the find outs, then you will get a clear understanding about what you are actually going to do, going to learn from this. Then you have to think. For example, if you want to learn about ecosystem, after reading this find out statement, what did you understand? So what is your goal now? I need to find out what the parts of an ecosystem are and how they are organized. This is what you want to learn from this. But immediately you cannot start reading the textbook because you have to look at the vocabulary words and be sure that you can pronounce each word. Particularly when you read any science textbook, there are a lot of scientific terminology that you have to know about. And the vocabulary, especially the scientific vocabulary, they may be sometimes difficult to pronounce. So you should have thorough knowledge about the vocabulary, especially the meaning of the vocabulary that you come across while reading these paragraphs, and how to pronounce this vocabulary you should also be knowing about it. Then only you can further proceed with reading. And how to know the vocabulary? You can find out the vocabulary and its meaning by looking at the glossary, which is given at the end of every lesson, and in some textbooks it is given at the end of the textbook. So you have to find out the glossary. You need to list out the glossary, refer a dictionary, take the help of internet or refer a dictionary. Then first of all, before you start beginning, find out the glossary that you came across. Before you start, if you learn about the glossary, it becomes very easy for you to read that concept and acquire that knowledge very quickly. Okay, and then say the definition to yourself. And there are some vocabularies which are definitions. And for example, when you are reading about autotrophic mode of nutrition, you may come across some words such as photosynthesis, autotrophs, right? So you need to know the definition of photosynthesis. Then only it becomes easy for you to understand about what are autotrophic organisms. Like that, you will come across different types of definitions when you read. While you are reading, you have to simultaneously understand the definitions, and that is possible only when you learn the definitions and vocabulary before you start reading the book. And then you have to think, come back to the example again, that I need to know what an ecosystem is. I need to read to find out what the parts in an ecosystem. Okay, the heading of different ecosystems gives a clue that it may have both living and non-living parts. Before you start reading the textbook, after looking at the find out statement or looking at the subheading, you can just make a guess. You can think that what you are going to find out by this. So as you are reading about ecosystem, you need to know about what an ecosystem is. And by looking at the heading, you can also see some of the things that ecosystem is made up of living and non-living things, right? And the heading different ecosystems gives clue that it may have both living and non-living parts. So this is what you have to think, and this is what you have to do before you start reading. Now let us find out what you have to do during reading process. Find the main idea of the topic. When you start reading, you have to find the main idea of the topic. After you start reading, after completing one paragraph or two paragraphs, definitely you will get what is the basic idea, what is the main idea of the topic. In this case, for example, group of living and non-living things make up an ecosystem. So in this case, that is the main idea. Ecosystem is formed by group of living things and non-living things. They will be interacting with each other, exchanging the materials with each other. This is the main idea. And we are going to further proceed with the details of an ecosystem. Find details in the next paragraph that supports the main idea. In main idea, what is an ecosystem is given, and in the further paragraphs, and definitely explanation to the main idea will be given in the next paragraphs, which you definitely have to read. Okay, for example, plant and animals in an ecosystem can meet all their basic needs in their ecosystem. Okay, what does it mean by plants and animals both are there? And plants and animals, both of them, they meet their basic requirements. What are the basic needs? Food is the basic requirement. Water is the basic requirement. Shelter is the basic requirement. Okay, so these basic requirements are met by plants and animals within the ecosystem. They need not go anywhere else away from the ecosystem. Within the ecosystem itself, they can find them. Check your understanding of what you have read by trying to answer the questions at the end of each session. So after learning some details about the main idea, after completion of 2-3 paragraphs or completion of a particular portion of that textbook or lesson, then you have to check your understanding of what you have read by trying to answer the questions at the end of each section. At the end of each section, some questions will be there. For example, it is given about interdependence between the biotic components. And at the end of the session, some questions are given. What do arrow marks in the figure indicate? Trace the path from grass to tiger. Like that, at the end of each session in your textbook, there will be some questions given, and you have to try to answer that questions on your own. And if you are unable to answer the questions, you can go back to the previous paragraphs where you can find answer to these questions. Right? So that's why it is very important for you to definitely try to answer the questions that are given after each section of the textbook. If you are not sure of the answers, reread the section and look for the answers to the questions. It doesn't mean that only once you can read. You cannot get anything only by reading once or twice. Thoroughly you have to read if you want to get thorough understanding of the concept. If you are able to answer the questions after completion of the section, then you can further proceed with other session. This is what you have to do during the reading process. And what should you do after reading process? After reading, you have to summarize what you have read. Are you getting my point? You have to summarize. Summary means just recalling all the important points that you have learnt during this reading. Think about what you have already learned about ecosystems and interactions. See, we have learned about ecosystems. We have learned the definition of ecosystem. And in this chapter only, it is given about interactions between the living and non-living components. Right? And some questions also given. You have read all these things. Now you have to think about what you have already learned about ecosystem and interactions. You have to frame some questions yourself and ask yourself and try to answer that questions. For example, in this case, you can ask yourself, what kind of system is an ecosystem? What interactions occur in an ecosystem? Already you have read about ecosystem, interactions about ecosystem in this section, right? Now you have to ask yourself, what kind of system is an ecosystem? What interactions occur in an ecosystem? These are the questions that you are framing and asking yourself. This definitely is going to improve your knowledge. And afterwards, you have to study the photographs and illustrations. For example, in this page, there is an illustration given. So this is the illustration given in this page. It is not a photograph. It is just an illustration where it is a small drawing, right? And you have to study that. What is given in that? Everything about ecosystem is given. And how do you know what type of illustration is that or what picture is it about? For that, you have to read the captions and label. Say, for instance, below this illustration, there is a caption given. Figure 5, food web in Coringa ecosystem. This is the caption. By looking at this caption, you will understand what is this illustration about or what the picture about. And this you have to do after reading the session. And don't think that the diagram you have to study only after reading the session. Sometimes when you are learning about the anatomy of human body, you have to simultaneously look at the picture when you are reading. Okay, but sometimes you have to look at the picture after completion of the section. Okay, so after this, you have to think about what is given in the picture. For example, in this case, you have to think about what kind of ecosystem is shown in the photographs. So this is the picture given. Already caption is given. So what kind of ecosystem is given here? Very simple. What is it? It is Coringa ecosystem, right? So reading about the science helps you understand the conclusions you have made based on your investigations. Okay, students, this is how you have to complete the reading process. So these are the steps you have to keep in mind, what you should do before reading, while reading and after reading. And if you follow these steps, definitely you are going to acquire knowledge in a better way. I hope that you understood, and I hope that you will follow these steps in reading when you read your science textbooks from here onwards. Okay, children, that's all for today. I will meet you in my next session.